three.
Oh my gosh.
So first of all, very exciting day today. Dan Goosen, we're here, December 31st, Anaheim Convention Center. What's going to happen on New Year's Eve?
Ellie, I thought for sure that you're going to say it was a very exciting day because you're here.
No.
That's true.
You know what's funny? I get the extremes. They either do like the sign, like the devil's coming, or they're really happy to see me. I don't have a happy medium.
Well, let's face it, okay? Without the devil, we don't have Jesus. And you know we have Jesus, so if they call any of us a devil, you know we're always protected, okay? We're always ready to overcome that. So, and you've done that through the years, because I know, what, you got millions and millions and millions of people that watch you, okay? And that's what it's about. So, you know, all I can tell you is that, this sport's about the best fighting the best, okay? And I really think that we've really kind of turned that big corner that the promoters as a whole understand that. And you know, the fans will come out, okay? The fans will come out. All you got to do is have the fights that they want to see. So the guys like Rigondeaux and Ramos, they're unknown. They're unknown to the people right now, but it's these type of fights that'll be able to make an impression for the winner. Okay, I don't know who's going to win it, Ellie, but I know it's a back and forth fight.
Rico's a champion from LA.
Right.
He works hard. Rigondeaux had something like 400 amateur fights in Cuba.
Yeah.
As a professional, he doesn't have that many fights, but when you have 400 fights under your belt, how do you see that fight going?
Well, as we know, with the Cubans that turned professional in today's world, it's the fast track. I mean, you see it with Gamboa. You see it with Guillermo. Okay, Rigondeaux. They all want it now because they feel the amateur pedigree that they grew up in, 300, 400 fights, have prepared them to step right into the professional ranks.